Hi everyone, my name is Yalith, and this afternoon I'm going to be teaching a 60-minute soul flow. We're going to be focusing on sun salutations, celebrating International Yoga Day today, and I think yesterday was the first day of summer, so pretty exciting. I am going to be playing music if at any point you think the music is too loud over my voice or that you can't hear the music well enough, I can adjust that. So just shout out and let me know. Otherwise, I'm gonna check the chat real quick to somebody. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and get started in Sukhasana or easy pose or any other comfortable seat, sitting up on as many blocks or blankets as you'd like. Just finding a way to get comfortable on your mat. You can bring your hands to your knees. You take a deep breath in. And exhale, sort of settle your shoulders down your back. Sending a nice tall spine up to the crown of your head. Just taking a moment here to come into the space. And some nice long inhales and exhales. And eventually with an exhale, allowing your eyes to close. Moment here to check in with your body, gently scanning through different layers of the physical body, mental, emotional, and energetic. Just noticing how you feel coming to your mat today. Without judgment or trying to change or fix anything, observing how the body feels in this present moment. And eventually, if you'd like to join me, we'll start to cultivate an ujjayi breath, an audible breath we use throughout our practice. If you know where you're going, go ahead. Otherwise, taking a deep inhale through your nose and exhale through an open mouth as if you're fogging up a window. Eventually the lips close, and then finding that same tension in the back of your throat on both the inhales and the exhales. Through your nose, creating that audible breath. My invitation is to allow that breath to carry you through the practice, allowing the breath to initiate the movement. And if needed throughout the practice, coming back to the audible sound of that breath as a way to draw your attention back to the present moment and back to what you're doing. We'll find this breath now for a few minutes in stillness so that we can use it throughout the practice. An anchor of strength.
Baby, ain't got no money. All I got is time, man. I'm gonna spend that time on you.
Once you're ready, allowing your eyes to flutter open. I can buy the sunshine, take coming you back into the sea. We'll drink champagne while hold up. Once you're ready, inhale, both arms up overhead. Taking some salutation breaths on your mat here. Exhale, bring your hands to heart something. We'll take that a few more times. Inhale, arms sweep up overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Already allowing the breath to initiate this movement as we take one more inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. To find this prayer pose, Anjali Mudra. Noticing if you can feel the energy balancing between right and left side body. You grow up nice and tall. Eventually, you can release your hands to your knees and we'll start moving here. Go ahead and walk your left fingers out to the left side of your mat and inhale, right arm up overhead, finding a nice side body stretch here. Inhale, finding even more length in your right side body, and exhale, think of grounding your right sit bones down into the earth. To feel a love like this, stronger than anyone else. Try not to collapse into the left side of your body, but rather finding length on both sides. Energizing through right fingertips. Maybe your gaze shifts up or down, depending on what feels good in your body. We'll stay here for one more inhale, finding even more length. Exhale to round through your back, finding right hand to left knee. Inhale to roll up to your spine. Left hand comes behind you, taking a gentle twist here. Inhale to find length in your spine, and exhale to twist a little bit deeper. As you're here, maybe thinking of pulling the right shoulder blade away from your spine and left shoulder blade towards your spine. Love, but I know that can see us through. It might sound crazy. Doing that while rotating your pelvis back towards the center of the space. Hold up in the room, that's how we spend our summer. As you're ready, inhale now, taking left arm up overhead, stay in the twist for another side body stretch here. Right hand can stay on left knee as you think more about touching up than taking a deep bend. Stay here for an inhale, exhale to round your back, left hand to right knee. Release your chin down to your chest to curl over. Let your head hang heavy. Inhale to slowly roll up, coming back to a neutral spine. And as you're ready, we'll take that to the other side. Now walking right fingertips out to the side of your mat. Inhale, left arm up overhead. Extending through left fingertips. On your exhale, can you think of grounding your left hip down into the mat? Again, finding length in both sides of your body. Your breath is flowing here. Maybe thinking of pulling your left thumb to the back wall behind you to further open up your rib cage. Here for one more inhale. Exhale to round your spine. Now finding left hand to right knee. Inhale, rolling up to your spine. Finding now your right hand back behind you for a twist. Can you think of moving your left shoulder blade away from your spine and right shoulder blade towards your spine? While finding length up to your spine on every inhale. Be energetically turning your hip bones back to face the front of the space. Your breath is flowing here. Doesn't need to be the deepest twist ever. We're just starting to move through the spine. Stay here for another breath in and a full breath out. Inhale now, bringing right arm up overhead, maintaining that twist for another side body stretch here. And you're really extending through your right side body. Right fingertips extend up towards the sky. Stay for an inhale. Exhale, round your back, finding right hand to left knee. Take a moment to let your head hang heavy, chin to chest, rounding through your spine. As you're ready, slowly rolling up back to Sukhasana. Hands can come to your knees. You're taking the effects of that on your body. Noticing how that movement maybe makes your spine feel a little bit more ready to go. And as you're ready, we'll come over our feet. Coming into tabletop pose. Finding wrists under shoulders, knees under hips. You think of pressing finger pads into the earth to find strength spiraling up from your hands all the way to your shoulders. Also thinking of scooping your navel up towards your spine. Engage Uddiyana Bandha. Breathing here for just a second. And as you're ready, moving through any movement of the spine, taking some cat and cow. Inhale to release the belly down towards the earth, arching through the back, gaze shifting up. Exhale to press the floor away, rounding the back, chin to chest. Inhale to cow pose, arching through the back, thinking of dialing your tailbone up and opening through your shoulders. Exhale to press the floor away, rounding your back, chin to chest. Move through that at your own breath pace a few more times. Allowing the breath to carry the movement. And you luxuriate through each vertebra of your spine. For these last few breaths here, maybe taking some other movement, like C-shape, looking over one shoulder, out your hip, and then to the other side. Or any other movement here that feels good. Eventually coming to find a moment of stillness in your tabletop pose. On your next inhale, extend your right leg back behind you and take a moment here to press through that ankle. Finding a stretch along the back side of your body, back side of your leg. Your breath is flowing. As you're ready, walk your left hand to the center of your mat. Wag the tail, moving left foot out to the side of your mat, and inhale to draw your hand up through your heart, extending up overhead for a fallen gate pose variation. Keep energy up through your fingertips. As you're ready, coming up to tented fingertips on your bottom leg, we'll come all the way up into gate pose, arms wide to a T. Opening through your chest. Inhale, we'll take both arms up overhead, upward salute. Breathing nice and long, maybe finding a little back bend with your gaze between your palms. Exhale, so open your arms back to a T and come back into that fallen gate pose nice and slowly. Left hand meets the mat. Stay for an inhale. Exhale, right hand comes back to the mat. Turning your hips down to face the mat. And finally releasing right leg to the earth. We'll take the same thing to the other side. On an inhale, extend left leg back behind you. Take a few breaths to press into that ankle, finding a stretch through the back of the leg. As you're ready, walk right hand to the center of your mat, wag your tail to open your right knee, and inhale, left arm through your chest, extending up to the sky, planting left foot onto the earth. You stack wrist on top of shoulder, on top of shoulder, on top of wrist here. Take a breath in, a breath out. As you're ready, coming up onto tented fingertips here as you transfer weight, coming up into Paragasana Gate Pose. Arms wide to a T. Inhale, both arms up overhead. Finding a little bit of a back bend here. Gazing between your palms. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, can you find a little bit more length through your fingertips? Exhale, arms come back out to a T, slowly tilting back into that fallen gate pose. Inhale here, exhale, left arm comes back to the mat. Left knee comes back to tabletop pose. Take a moment for any other movement of the spine, any other wriggles here. And as you're ready, check your toes. Inhale here. Exhale, press back, downward facing dog. Take a moment here for any conscious movement. Maybe pedaling through your legs. You look under one arm and the other. Or maybe taking a deep bend in both knees, allowing hips to dial up towards the sky. Eventually finding a moment of stillness here in your downward facing dog, even weight in your hands and feet as your heels press down towards the earth, clawing finger pads into the mat to engage all of the muscles in your hands, wrists spiraling up to support your shoulders. Inhale to rise up high on your toes, look to the front of your mat, and at the bottom of your exhale, take tiny steps forward between your mat. Between your hands for forward fold. Find opposite hand to opposite elbow as you release your head, neck, shoulders heavy to the mat. Maybe swing a little bit from side to side. Eventually releasing your hands. Deeply bend your knees and slowly, as you're ready, rolling up through every vertebrae, coming up to Tadasana Mountain Pose. Feel your shoulder blades down your spine, extend through your fingertips. Take a breath here. Coming to find yourself grounding into your feet. Inhale, bring both arms up overhead, Urdhva Hastasana, upward salute. Exhale, deeply bend your knees, swan dive forward, forward fold. Option to find blocks under your hands here or for any of the flows throughout this class. Inhale, halfway lift, coming to fingertips or hands to legs. Exhale, fold, take a large right step back into a runner's lunge. Squaring off your hips, thinking of energizing through both of your legs as if you could take your hands off the mat. Stay for an inhale. Exhale to release knee and foot to the mat. Inhale, arms overhead. Anjanasana, knee down crescent. Extending through fingertips. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Is flowing. Stay for one more inhale here. Exhale, hands to the mat, framing your foot, tuck your toes, extending through your back leg, and step back to plank pose. Take a moment to find a nice strong pose here. Stay for an inhale. Exhale to release knees and feet to the mat and slowly lower all the way down to your belly. Replace your hands under your shoulders. Inhale to peel up off the mat. Cobra pose. take a moment here, only pushing up as far as is comfortable for you right now. Hug your elbows towards your ribs. You can go tractioning elbows back towards your hips for a deeper back bend here. Stay for an inhale. Exhale to release down to the mat. Inhale through tabletop. Exhale, downward facing dog. Taking a moment in your downward facing dog for any movement here. As you're ready, inhale to take a large right step forward between your hands. Again, finding that runner's lunge, stabilizing through your legs, open through your shoulders, stay for an inhale. Exhale, releasing left knee and foot down to the mat. Inhale, arms overhead, just for a breath. Exhale, hands to the earth, framing your foot, tuck back toes. And on your exhale, take a large left step forward to meet your right foot at the front of the mat. Release into this forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Grounding through your feet. Inhale, arms sweep up overhead. Urdhva Hastasana, upward salute. Exhale, hands to heart center. Stay for a breath. Inhale, we'll take that to the other side. Arms up, upward salute. Exhale, swan dive forward. Release your head, neck, and shoulders heavy. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Take a large left step back. Runner's lunge. Thinking of finding stable hips, pressing legs into the earth. As if you could hover hands. Stay for an inhale. Exhale, release knee and foot to the earth. Inhale, arms overhead. Onto my asana, knee down crescent. Staying for a few breaths here. On your inhale, can you think of finding even more length up to your fingertips as if you could touch the sky? Exhale, maybe sinking a little bit deeper. Finding a slight back bend here. Breath is flowing. Take another inhale. Exhale, hands to the mat, framing your foot. Tuck your back toes, energize through your leg, and step back to plank pose. Stay for an inhale and an exhale. Inhale, exhale, knees and feet release, lower all the way down to your belly. Replace hands under shoulders. Inhale, peeling body up off the mat. Retraction your shoulders, your elbows back towards the hips, opening through your chest. Inhale, exhale, release down to the mat. Inhale through tabletop. Exhale, downward facing dog. Dropping your heart through your arms. Staying here for a breath. As you're ready, inhale to take a large left step forward between your hands. Coming back into that runner's lunge, stabilizing through legs. Inhale and exhale. Stay for one more inhale. Exhale, release knee and foot to the earth. Inhale for one breath, arms overhead. Exhale, hands to the earth. Tucking back toes, take a large right step forward to meet your left foot at the front of your mat. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Grounding through feet. Inhale, arms rise up overhead. Upward salute. Exhale, hands to heart center. Stay here for a breath. Thinking of releasing your shoulder blades down your back. As you're ready, we'll move through a couple rounds of Sun A. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, swan dive forward. Hands plant on the mat, step back, plank pose. Option to continue with knees down cobra or shifting far over your wrists. Slowly bend elbows so that your chest is hovering off the mat. Inhale to press up to upward facing dog. Thighs stay off the mat. And an exhale to press directly back to downward facing dog. When you arrive in downward dog, taking just a breath here. breath in and a breath out. Inhale to rise up high onto your toes. Look to the front of your mat, and at the bottom of your exhale, step or float between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Grounding to your feet. Inhale, arms overhead. Upwards, loop. Exhale, hands to heart center. We'll take one more like that with either variation. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Step back, plank pose. Take knees down, cobra or chaturanga to upward facing dog. We'll meet in downward facing dog. Finding a breath in downward facing dog. Inhale, rise up high on your toes. Look to the front of your mat, and at the bottom of your exhale, step or float between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Ground through your feet. Inhale, arms overhead, upwards lift. Exhale, hands start center. Moving into a variation of Sun D. Go ahead and find your feet at hip distance at the front of your mat. Deeply bend your knees, sinking hips back. Arms go in a big circle all the way up overhead for Utkatasana chair pose. Inhale to find more length through your arms. Exhale, sink a little bit deeper. Breath is flowing here. As you stay for one more inhale, exhale to fold forward. Releasing head, neck, and shoulders. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale to fold, step back to plank pose. Take your vinyasa, either knees down cobra or chaturanga upward facing dog to eventually arrive in downward facing dog.
Okay, I was drunk as hell. Okay.
Inhale, so lift right leg up off the mat once you're in downward facing dog. Exhale to take a large right step forward between your hands. Spiral back heel down. We're going into warrior one. Feet can stay wide on train tracks or heels in line with each other. Grounding through your feet. Inhale, arms overhead. Warrior one. Breathing in and out. Finding even more length up to your fingertips as you find grounding into your legs. You think of scissoring your legs together energetically as if you could pull them together. Inhale, exhale, hands to the earth. Dial back leg down, step back, plank pose. Stay for an inhale. Exhale, release knees and feet to the earth and lower all the way down to your belly. Or take chaturanga to upward facing dog. Inhale, up dog or cobra pose. Exhale, releasing to the earth. Inhale through table. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a breath here. Inhale, now lifting left leg up off the mat. Exhale, take a large left step forward between your hands. Again, setting up for warrior one. Spiral back, heel down. Find strength in your legs. Inhale. Arms up overhead, warrior one. You think of letting your tailbone waterfall down your spine to find a nice straight back here. Inhale, extending through your fingertips. Exhale, grounding into the earth. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, exhale, hands to the earth. Step back, plank pose. Take your variation, finding downward facing dog. Still allowing that luxurious quality of breath, blanking to movement. Eventually finding downward facing dog. Inhale to rise up high onto your toes, look to the front of your mat, and at the bottom of your exhale, step or float between your hands. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Grounding through feet. Inhale, arms up overhead, upward salute. Exhale, hands to heart center. Deeply bend your knees, arms take a full circle all the way up overhead, chair pose. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale, sink a little bit deeper. Inhale, straighten through your knees, extend arms up overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Take a breath here. Inhale, arms up overhead. Exhale to fold forward. Step back to plank pose. Take your variation or just press back to downward facing dog. As you find downward facing dog, take a few breaths either in downward facing dog or child's pose. Allowing the heart to melt through the arms. You're ready. A few more breaths where you are. And eventually we all meet back in a downward facing dog. Taking a breath to balance weight between hands and feet. Let your head relax to neutral. You're breathing here. When you're ready, walk feet together at the back of your mat, big toes touch. Inhale to lift right leg up overhead for a three-legged dog, hips stack on top of hip. Pressing into your hands, find even weight in both hands, supporting through both shoulders. Stay for an inhale. Exhale to take a large right step forward between your hands. We're going towards warrior two. Finding your right foot to the center of your mat, spiral back foot down so that front heel is in line with back mid-foot. Inhale to rise, exhale to settle, warrior two. Can you again think of waterfall in your tailbone down? Find a nice long lower back and engaging your lower belly. Breathing here. Breath is flowing, legs are strong into the floor. Inhale, straightening your front knee, arms up overhead. Go ahead and turn both feet to face the side of your mat. Inhale. Exhale to fold forward into a wide-legged forward fold. Taking any movement here that feels good. Maybe bending into one knee and then the other. Let everything relax towards the earth. You think of dialing hips up towards the sky. You're ready. Inhale to ground to your feet. Upward salute. Arms up overhead. Exhale, turn your front foot back to the front of your mat. And exhale, sinking back into warrior two. Here's warrior two here. Trying to find a 90-degree bend in the front knee. Inhale, reversing your prayer. Left hand can come to left thigh or wrap around your body as you stay for an inhale. Exhale, coming into side angle pose. Right hand to right knee. Left arm extending up overhead. Option to stay here or to extend both arms long, finding right hand to the inside of your right foot. wherever you are, stay for an inhale. Exhale, finding both hands, framing your front foot. Taking a nice long sweep of your left hand. Inhale to step back to plank pose. Take your variation here. We meet in downward facing dog. Take a breath in downward facing dog. Inhale through your nose. And out through an open mouth. Breath is flowing. As you're ready, step feet together at the back of your mat. Big toes touch. Inhale now to float left leg up off the mat. Hip stack on top of the hip. Table eyes through both shoulders. Breathing here. Inhale and exhale. Stay for one more inhale. Exhale to take a large left step forward between your hands. Foot comes to the center of the mat. We're setting up for warrior two. Front heel in line with back mid plank. Inhale over to rise. Exhale to settle warrior two. Breathing here. You feel the outsides of your feet pressing into the earth. As your left knee travels over the outside of your left foot. Breathing here. For one more breath in and a full breath out. Inhale, straighten your front knee, arms overhead. You need to turn both feet to face the side of your mat. Turn around to face you. You can stay where you are. Inhale here, exhale to fold forward. Release everything down to the earth. As you're ready, ground through your feet. Inhale, arms up overhead. Upward salute. Exhale, turning left foot back to the front of your mat. Exhale, sinking down, warrior two. Always waiting for you to be waiting below. Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. What doesn't kill me makes me want you more. The tailbone waterfall down your spine. Inhale, reversing your warrior. Standing through your left fingertips. Inhale here. Exhale, left elbow to left knee, side angle pose. Keeping a deep bend in your front knee. Option to stay here or to open both arms, left hand in front of left foot. Breathing here. Inhale and exhale. Inhale to find more length through your fingertips. Taking a big sweeping motion of the right hand all the way to the floor. Inhale to step back to plank pose. Take your variation, left vinyasa of the class. We'll make in downward facing dog. Exhale, press back downward facing dog. Pressing through your hands and feet. Release your head, neck, and shoulders. Inhale to rise up high onto your toes. Look to the front of your mat. And at the bottom of your exhale, step or float between your hands. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale to fold, grounding through feet. Inhale, arms overhead, upward pull. Exhale, hands to heart center. When you're ready, we'll start to move into variations of tree pose. You can go ahead and keep your hands at your heart center. And step feet together at the front of your mat, so big toes touch. Broadening through your collarbones, grounding in all four corners of your feet. Eventually starting to shift weight into your left foot. Maybe your right foot comes here to a kickstand. This is a great place to stay. Finding grounding into your left foot. Maybe your right foot comes to your left calf. Maybe you use the help of your hands to bring right foot all the way up to left thigh. Being sure not to put the right foot on your knee directly. Gaze straight forward. Maybe you stay here, maybe you take an inhale to bring arms up overhead. Breath is flowing. Permission to come in and out of this pose as much as you'd like. Breath is flowing for one more inhale. And an exhale. Inhale to release your foot, bringing your knee up towards your chest, keeping that foot up off the ground for one legged tadasana. And exhale to release it down to the earth. And step for the other side, finding big toes touch, jumping on the heart center. As you're ready, maybe you find a kickstand with your left foot. As your left foot is on your right ankle, maybe you come to find left foot on right calf. Maybe you go further, bringing left foot all the way up to right thigh. Again, being sure not to place your left foot on your right knee, rather putting it above or below. Option to stay here or to inhale, both arms up overhead. Use the energy up through your fingertips to balance you here. Your breath is flowing, gaze is sharp in front of you. Breathing here. For one more inhale and a full exhale. Inhale to release your foot from your leg, coming to one leg, standing tadasana, knee towards chest. Exhale to release foot down to the earth. Try not to shake out your legs just yet. Inhale, arms overhead, upward salute, and exhale to take a nice forward fold. Enjoy this forward fold, releasing head, neck, shoulders down to the earth. Bending your knees as deeply as you'd like. As you're ready, walk your fingers out towards the front of your mat as if you're going into a downward facing dog in your upper body. Exhale to slowly sink hips down. If this doesn't feel great, option to come into a seated pose in any other way. Eventually, lowering your hips to the earth. So come back to Sukhasana or easy pose. Take a moment sitting here the same way that we did at the start of the practice, noticing any changes in the body. If you're ready, we'll take a few more of the sun breaths that we did to start the class. Inhale, sweeping both arms up overhead. Exhale, bring arms to heart center. Starting to slow down here, moving slowly. If you're moving through water, inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Take one more like that, inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Stay here for a breath. You're ready, you can release your hands to your knees or by your side. Come to find your feet planted on the floor, knees pointing up to the sky. You can bring your hands to the back of your thighs and slowly roll all the way down to your back. We're setting up for bridge pose. You can take any variation of this pose that you like, whether that's a supported bridge pose, a sustained bridge pose, or maybe some waving bridges. Whatever feels good in your body today. If you're going for the active option, wait for an inhale. And exhale to press your heels into the floor, lifting up to the sky. Maybe hands clasp behind your back. As you walk your shoulder blades under your spine, keeping your gaze straight up to the sky. You lift the hips a little bit higher. Love is flowing here. I want you to come in and out of this pose, or to find yourself sustaining here. Take just a few more breaths. One more inhale, lift the hips a little bit higher. Exhale, coming all the way down to the earth. Take a moment, come to your knees, pointing up to the sky. To reset the body, eventually coming to take a wide-legged child's pose on your back, knees go wide. Finding a spinal neutralizer here. Option to find hands to the outsides or insides of your feet for happy baby. Maybe taking a little movement from side to side. Stay here for an inhale and exhale to release the grip on your hands. Use your hands to guide your knees together and eventually find planting on the earth, knees pointing up. When you're ready, we'll cross right ankle over left knee, coming into a figure four stretch. Take your right hand and gently press open your right knee. Finding some hip opening here. Stay here for a few breaths. Stay for one more inhale, exhale to go into a little bit of a twist here, releasing your left knee open. Right foot can plant on the earth. Taking arms maybe wide to a T, or if you're more comfortable keeping your hands by your sides or on your belly, anywhere that feels good. Eventually taking the left hand to gently press open right knee here. For a breath in, and full breath out. Inhale to come back to center, keeping that right knee on top of your left. Inhale, now pulling, if you'd like, right knee in towards your chest, left knee in towards your chest. Hands can come behind your left thigh. You energetically press right ankle into left knee. Breath is flowing here. Option to stay here, option to extend your left leg long, adding a little bit of a hamstring stretch. Breath is flowing. As you relax into this pose. Stay for one more inhale. Exhale to release your left foot down to the earth, keeping your right ankle crossed. And go ahead and find either a strap around your right foot or your two peace fingers around right big toe. Eventually extending our leg long for a hamstring stretch here. Whether you have a strap or your hand on your right foot, finding a little bit of resistance, pressing energetically your foot out into your hand or the strap. Breath is flowing here. When you're ready, inhale to peel head, neck, shoulders up off the ground. Right elbow goes wide. Exhale to release down to the earth. We'll take one more like that. Inhale to peel head, neck, shoulders up off the mat. Right elbow pulls wide. Exhale, release. Eventually releasing the grip onto your leg. Extend your left leg long. Slowly allow the right leg to float all the way down to the earth. Take a moment to notice differences between right and left side body. Eventually coming to draw both knees pointing up to the sky, feet planted on the floor. We'll take the same sequence to the other side. As you're ready, cross left ankle over right knee. Eventually coming to gently press open left knee with left hand. Stay here for one more inhale. Exhale to slowly release. Legs over to the right side, planting left foot on the earth. For a little bit of a twist here. You find the right hand to the inside of the left knee and gently press it open.
Drinking from plastic cups, singing love is forever and never. Well, I guess that was true.
As you're ready, release your right hand from your right, from your left knee. Slowly come back up to center. Option to stay here or to pull right knee in towards your chest. Hands can go behind your right thigh. Energetically press left ankle into right knee. Option to stay here or to extend right leg long up to the sky. We'll add a little hamstring stretch. It's flowing. Stay for one more inhale. Exhale to slowly release right foot down to the earth, keeping left ankle crossed. Again, now finding breath around your left foot or your two peace fingers. Inhale to extend your leg up overhead. Finding a hamstring stretch here. Notice how one side might feel very different than the other. Your breath is flowing. Inhale to peel head, neck, shoulders up off the mat. Left elbow goes wide. Exhale to release down, taking that one more time. Inhale, head, neck, and shoulders peel up off the mat. Exhale, release down to the earth. Stay here for another breath. If you're ready, release the grip on your leg. Extend right leg long and slowly allow left leg to float down to the earth. Taking a moment to notice the effects of that in the body. Eventually again coming to find feet on the earth, knees pointed up. On the day you fell in love, love. go ahead and hug your knees into your chest, giving them a squeeze, maybe rocking a little bit left and right, up and down your mat.
To my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turn brown.
As you're ready, shift your hips a couple inches over to the right and allow your knees to release over to the left side of your mat for a reclined twist. When you're there, maybe your gaze shifts over your right hand.
When I met you in the summer.
As it's flowing, if your right shoulder is heavy to the mat. If you're ready, I'll stay here for a few more breaths. Even further into the air. On your inhale, gaze shifts back up to the sky. Slowly pull your knees further in towards your chest as you slowly roll back onto your back. Take a moment to set up for the other side. Now shifting hips a couple inches over to the left side of your mat. And exhale, releases your legs over to the right side of your body. When you're there, option to turn. Head over left hand. Recline twist. Left shoulder is heavy to the earth. We'll be here for a few more breaths, allowing the body to melt into this pose. As you're ready, inhale to shift your back up to the sky. Slowly pull your knees in towards your chest as you roll back onto your back. Allow your hips to neutralize and take any more movement in a cool down fashion that feels good to you. Maybe coming back into happy baby or hugging your knees into your chest, rocking back and forth and up and down your mat.
The sun goes down. Stars come out and all that comes.
Maybe eventually coming to curl your head up off the mat, curling into a tiny little ball. And eventually exhale to extend legs, arms long, coming into Shavasana. Letting everything release here. Let your body be heavy into the mat. You stay here for an inhale. Then exhale to allow your eyes to close and release control of your breath, allowing it to return to its natural rhythm.
She's hard.
Allow your body to be heavy into the mat. As if you could melt a little bit more with each breath out. To again tune into and bring your awareness to your body, gently scanning through your physical, mental, emotional, and energetic body, noticing any differences now from the beginning of class. Again, without judgment or trying to change or fix anything, just asking yourself, how do I feel in this present moment? Sky got a certain shade of blue, the kind that heaven's fixing up for you. And eventually, the entire body is relaxed. Let go of any attention altogether, any focus. Just be here. As you're ready, start to deepen your breath. Invite subtle movement back into the body. Wiggling fingers and toes, circling ankles and wrists. Maybe taking a big full body stretch. And eventually come to roll onto your right side, using your right arm as a pillow. Take a moment on your side for gratitude to yourself for showing up on your mat today, to your body for carrying you through this practice, and for this practice and everything that it has to offer us on and off the mat. Eventually, press into your left hand, coming up to a comfortable seat. Hands can come to your knees, or if you'd like to join me, bringing hands to heart center. I honor the place in you in which the entire universe dwells. I honor the place in you that is of love, truth, of light, and of peace. If you are in that place in you, and I am in that place in me, we are one. If you'd like to join me, bringing thumb knuckles to third eye center, we'll seal this practice with the blessing of namaste. Namaste. Thank you for your practice.